Hi, I'm Paul Del Rio from Packy. While driving down a smooth asphalt road, have you ever wondered just how that asphalt mix is produced? Behind me is an asphalt plant where stone, sand, and recycled products are combined with liquid asphalt to make an efficient pavement material.
It all starts at the stockpiles. Each pile consists of a different aggregate ranging from coarser stone down to finer sands. A loader operator hauls stone from the piles to cold feed bins. Each bin holds a different size aggregate. A conveyor running below the bins feeds aggregates into the asphalt plant. The plant operator, working in an on-site control room, can adjust how much of each aggregate size is used in the mix. Usually, the aggregate enters a large rotating drum with a gas-powered burner flame on one end. The aggregate is completely dried by the burner. Once that happens, liquid asphalt is pumped from the heated storage tanks and added to the drum, where the rotation mixes it with the aggregates. Reclaimed asphalt pavement, or RAP, can also be sent to the drum through a separate cold feed bin and conveyor. Using these recycled materials reduces cost and is friendlier to the environment. A continuous plant, or drum plant, uses a drum to dry and also mix the liquid binder and aggregates together. It is the most common type of plant used in the United States. A batch plant also uses a drum to dry the aggregates, but then sends the dried material to a large batch tower, and then to a mixing chamber where the liquid binder and aggregates are combined. Once the asphalt is mixed thoroughly and heated, it is sent up to storage silos. Some silos are only designed to hold material for a short period of time. Other silos are heated and can store mixes for several days. Some plants will use more silos depending upon the number of different mix types needed. Beneath the silos is the loading area. Dump trucks will receive material and then haul it to the paving site. A weight scale is usually located on the loading ramp in order to discharge the correct amount of mix for usage. Once the truck is loaded, the driver is given the signal to transport the asphalt mix to where it's needed for safe, smooth, and economical roadway construction.